Sixth victim of the Bondi stabbing attack has been identified this hour. Yizhuan Cheng, joining the list of victims being mourned by the entire country.
Communities and flags across the country are being lowered to half-mast across the nation. This is Parliament House in Canberra earlier this morning. And in Sydney, a landmark known the world over right now, honouring the six innocent lives taken.
Our reporting team is across all the new developments for you at home this morning. First to Sarah Stewart with that breaking news. Sarah, good morning.
Yeah, good morning to you, Carl. We have now identified the sixth victim. She is a beautiful young woman called Yizhuan Cheng. She is a Chinese national who was here in Australia studying. Unfortunately, she doesn't have any family here in Australia. Police spent the day yesterday trying to contact her family back home in China. She was simply at Westfield on Saturday shopping like everybody else. Now, I can tell you that the six people have now been identified that lost their lives. Eight people remain in hospital this morning, including that nine-month-old baby girl. I can tell you that she's just woken up after spending her second night here at the children's hospital. Her family have released a statement. They say that she is doing well after extensive surgery on Saturday evening. We know she underwent hours of surgery, but she is in a serious but stable condition here at the children's hospital this morning. There are seven other people in hospital this morning as well. One person is in a critical condition. All of the others are listed in a serious but stable condition. And Carl, I can tell you with that confirmation this morning that three mothers have been killed in this attack. That means three lots of children no longer have their mother going home. It is simply heartbreaking.
Yeah, it truly is, Sarah. Thank you. Well, let's cross to Jack Hahn at Bondi Junction now with new developments in the investigation. Jack, police are wrapping up their operation there.
Yeah, that's right. Sarah, Carl, good morning to you. The New South Wales Police Force have confirmed that Bondi Junction Westfield is no longer a crime scene. But as you can see from behind me, Oxford Street is closed. Police still here. They are in the process of passing this scene back to the management of Westfield. The only people allowed in are to pick up their vehicles. The stores are still closed this morning. This has been a huge 40-hour investigation. It continues. But here is how Police Commissioner Karen Webb has described the police probe.
Many, many, and in fact hundreds of exhibits have been seized by police and will be now subject to forensic investigation over the coming days and weeks. In addition, detectives will be interviewing family members for those who died. That will be a slow and painstaking process, as you can imagine.
So multiple investigations are underway this morning. While a criminal investigation is not underway, a report will be prepared to the coroner, and a critical incident investigation is underway into the use of deadly force. Anyone with information should reach out to Crime Stoppers by calling 1800 333 000. Already 50 witnesses overnight have reached out to police.
Thank you, Jack.
That news about three mothers losing their lives.
It's
tough, isn't it?
Yeah.
Let's go to Sylvia now, who's at Bondi Junction. That's tough. Sylvia, the attention of the whole nation focused there where you are.
Oh, Carl and Sarah, we are a nation in mourning this morning, and nowhere is it more raw than here in Bondi Junction. This is a community that has been deeply affected by the tragic events of Saturday afternoon. And this tribute to the victims behind me continues to grow this morning. Just minutes ago, a young girl, no older than maybe 10 or 11, came here with her brother and her mother to lay a small bouquet of flowers here for the victims. And you could see the effect, you could see the pain and the grief on their faces. This is such a connected community. Everyone around here, and I know plenty of them, knows someone who was here on Saturday afternoon. The ripple effects will be very far and wide for days, weeks, probably months to come. And it's on the front page, of course, of every newspaper this morning. The Sydney Morning Herald with the simple word senseless on the front page, along with the faces of five of the innocent, bright lives that were taken in this terrible attack on Saturday. We were joined just moments ago also by New South Wales Police Minister Yasmin Catley, who confirmed to me here on the Today Show that New South Wales Police have now flown to Queensland, where they plan to interview the family of the attacker, 40-year-old Joel Couchy. They are, of course, hoping to answer the question that everyone has this morning: why did he carry out this horrific attack?
the New South Wales Police will be sending a contingent to Queensland to interview the family. They will not only interview the family, but also New South Wales Health and any of those agencies that Joel has had any interaction with. So that will help form part of the investigation into the why, I guess, and that's really what we need to do.
Strikingly, Karl and Sarah, we have seen a statement from Joel Couchy's parents who say they have no problem with the actions of the police officer, Inspector Amy Scott, who brought this rampage to an end and fatally shot their son throughout that rampage. They say that they understand she was doing her job to protect others.
We'll get on to him in just a second. But Sylvia, you and I spoke over the weekend, almost immediately after all this started. You live in that area. You would know people who know some of the victims and your mum. I mean, this is very, very difficult for people who don't have any direct contact, let alone people who do.
Oh, Karl, I'm like everyone in this area who knows people who were here. I know someone who was caught up in this, someone who was injured. I know people who hid in change rooms over the weekend, wondering if they would make it out. And you only have to look at the footage to see how traumatised everyone was. They were running for their lives without knowing which way to go. To see and to hear about a 38-year-old mother who came to a shopping centre, which is a safe place for a new mum, a place where they can come and find a safe feeding space, a safe changing room, you know, for a baby. This is supposed to be a safe haven for a new mother. Ashley Good's final act was to protect the life of her 9-month-old baby. And I just think that is so hard to fathom. It is so hard to comprehend. And like everyone, you know, my heart aches for her family, for her partner who was left behind, and everyone who has lost someone in this terrible tragedy this morning.
That's exactly right.
There is so much pain and so much trauma being felt right across the city and the country, I think, Sylvia. Thank you for that insight. And we are learning more about that killer. Andrea Crothers is following that part of the story for us from Ipswich. Andrea, we've heard from those who knew him.
Yeah, as Sylvia said, Joel Couchy's parents, they've broken their silence. He was very much estranged from his family, but in their statement, they also said they were devastated by the traumatic events and that his actions were horrific, also noting that he'd suffered mental health issues since he was a teenager. They first saw this footage broadcast and actually went to police themselves, believing it was their son involved. So he spent the majority of his life in Toowoomba, before moving away from there. Neighbours of their family home describe him as a troubled teen.
Oh, shocked. When I heard his name this morning, I couldn't believe it, because I'd say hello to him when he'd walk past and he'd say hello back, you know. He never talked much, but he'd say hello.
He was very much a drifter after that, though, moving around Brisbane, the Gold Coast, as well as here in Ipswich. Police, as they come up here to Queensland to try piece together exactly what motivation, if any, there was. We'll be looking at all of those things, guys.
Andrea, thank you.
We're also following breaking news from Sydney's north, where a man has died in a multi-vehicle accident on the M1. Sorry.
This happened just before 5 a.m, approximately 2 kilometres north of Wurrunga exit. Police say the car travelling southbound collided with 3 other vehicles travelling north. Northbound lanes are closed with traffic backed up southbound for more than 10 kilometres.
Breaking news
coming in from Deer Park in Melbourne, where a man has been arrested after a body was discovered in a house fire. The blaze broke out around 2:30 a.m. on Station Road, with police treating both the death and the fire as suspicious.
A mass pro-Palestinian protest has officially kicked off in Melbourne and police are at the ready. Today's Christina Hearn is in Melbourne with more. Chris, good morning. It's all kicking off as we speak.
Yeah, that's right, Sarah. I'm on the steps of State Parliament, where there is a rally just getting underway, as you can see. It is very peaceful at this stage. There is a large number of police that have gathered here on the steps of Parliament. Now, this is one of the areas we know. There's many areas around Melbourne and indeed the country that we don't know that this group A15 are targeting, all in support of Palestine. In Sydney this morning, three protesters targeted targeted the defence contractors Talis, and those three protesters have since been arrested. Here in Melbourne, just a short time ago, protesters targeted the exit ramp off the West Gate leading to the Port of Melbourne. That protest is still currently underway. As you can see, there is a lot of police. There's been hundreds of police that have been redeployed from regional centres stationed here in Melbourne for this day of action. The State Police Operations Centre has also been reactivated for the first time since the pandemic. Sarah.
Thanks, Chris.
Happening today, Bruce Lehrmann will learn whether he has been successful in his defamation case against Network 10 and Lisa Wilkinson. Mr. Lehrmann is suing over the project's 2019 interview, during which Brittany Higgins alleged she was raped by an unnamed colleague. The 28-year-old has always denied the rape allegation.
And some almost space news just in. NASA has been called upon to help locate the Loch Ness monster. The Loch Ness Centre is urging the space agency to lend its hand in a fresh hunt for the legendary beast on the 90th anniversary of Sir Edward Mountain's original expedition at the end of the month. It comes after one of the biggest water searches in the Highlands concluded with potential sightings and underwater noises last year.
Sorry, folks, we're just... This story is just so heavy.
It's really heavy.
And we are not the story, nor would we ever want to be. Mm. But dealing with this story and its magnitude, and how just awful it is for mothers and babies, it's a lot. So apologies for some of us getting upset at times. And it's in some of our communities.
And I think as well, you know, knowing that there were so many women affected, it's really hard. Yeah. You know, you see them and, you know, you see people that you love and they're friends of friends, and it's really tough.
And you think about their families as well and having to pick up the pieces. I mean, you know, we saw those queues yesterday of people having to go back to get the cars. I mean, imagine the partners and the loved ones of these people who you're looking at right now having to go back into that car park to get their cars. It sounds so mundane, but
their lives are changed.
Yeah.
They will never be the same. And just the magnitude of that grief, I think most of us can't and don't want to imagine. But these families have it. They will live by it. Their lives will forever be changed by it. So it's so heavy.
And some of them are so young. Yeah.
I mean, she was planning her wedding. The 25-year-old planning her wedding, bought her wedding dress just the other day.
She's going
and
to
then
get
now,
makeup.
I mean, she can't even get married. Yeah. Like, you've got a mother there who she just wanted to be a mum. It's all she wanted to be. First-time mother at 38, and had to throw her baby into strangers' arms for them to be saved.
So, folks, bear with us if you can, and we'll get back on track. Let's get ahead of the weather now with Mia, who's on the Gold Coast. Mia.
Yeah, thank you, guys. It is a really tough morning, isn't it? And it will be a tough couple of days as well, right around the country. But we are waking up on the Gold Coast this morning. But let's take a look at what is happening in your backyard. Cairns, it's going to be a couple of showers for you today and a top of 30 degrees. A partly cloudy one for Townsville and 31. The Sunshine Coast, mostly sunny with a top of 27. Brisbane and the Gold Coast, partly cloudy today and a top of 27 here for the Goldie, 28 for Brisbane. Sydney, the Harbour City, sunny and a top of 26 degrees today. The nation's capital, sunny one and a top of 20. Melbourne will partly cloudy for you today. Hobart too, partly cloudy as well. Into Adelaide, a mostly sunny one for you today and a top of 23 degrees. Perth, mostly fine and sunny and a top of 29. Geraldton sunny as well and a top of 32. Karratha and Broome, all sunny as well. Into the Alice, a sunny one for you today and a top of 29 degrees. And Darwin, sunny as well and a top of 35. And I will have more weather, guys, in around half an hour's time.